Yeah, they had me locked for a bit and I'm home now and I've just given a tester. To Brenda, she licked her pipe and told me that is the best one. We Bosch Madge in a pack if we need a little bit extra. TT Flake whip that and we make it stretcher. We make bread and the ops then press cuz. Too many times I've jumped in.
So as you see here guys, we're at the M52 engine. Now, a lot of you already have this engine. You guys are in a lot of misfire codes, rough running codes, you know, Vanos codes, and you guys don't know what to do. So I'm gonna explain to you what you need to do in order to fix them issues. And it does apply for the blacktop valve cover, because a lot of people see this video and think, does this apply for my engine? Yes, it does. If you've got 328i, 328xi, 528i, 528xi, it will apply for your engine. So just follow the advice given, because it seems like for like, the only difference is it's got a plastic valve cover. So the first one on these guys, as many of you guys will know, when you remove this plastic cover here, you've got your ignition coils underneath. The ignition coils on these do like to go out, and as I've said to many people, when they do go out, they usually throw a code. But on BMW, that's not the case, they don't. They'll leave you running in limp mode and not even throw a code until you push it down on wide open throttle, and it's under heavy load, it will throw a light. And they all sit under there. My best advice is to switch them around to see which one's failing and change that one out. But our best advice is, if they haven't all been changed ever before in their life, replace all six. I know a lot of you ain't gonna take this into consideration. You're just gonna ignore that and just go and replace one, because that's how many of you cheap out. You'll just replace the one when I'm telling you to replace all six, and then you don't listen to my advice, and then you come back with half the same issues. Replace all six and replace all six spark plugs at the same time. If you haven't seen my spark plug video, make sure to use the right spark plugs with the right gap as well. The next one that calls a lot of codes, and a lot of you like to use your cheap P0 scanners, and a lot of you like to get come to me with your crankshaft correlation codes. It is nothing to do with your engine, nothing to do with your Vanos adjusters at all, and you don't need a new engine like your indie shop said or your dealers or anything like that. They're only to tell you that. They're clearly mechanics and they shouldn't be allowed to even own a garage. Crankshaft correlation is because they're using cheap little scan tools, and these are responsible for them codes. They will give Vanos errors and cause loads of different errors. Your P0191, these will be your problem as well. This is your problem right here, the Vanos solenoid. So if your mechanic's trying to change out your camshaft sensors, they don't really fail. This is your failure right there. So if you're getting crankshaft correlation codes, your Vanos solenoids are the ones that will cause them codes. So make sure that you change them out. Do not need a new engine, so do not listen to your indie garage. And if they're telling you that, run away and never go back, because that means they're trying to rob you, and it's not a good sign. The next one that can cause you rough running. Now, a lot of you are going to ask me, do I have these on my car? No. If you've got a 328i, you're not going to have these. If you've got a 330i, you have to have this engine cover to have this. So if you don't have this color engine cover, you will not have these. But the next one that will cause rough running, misfires, and can cause vacuum leaks is the disser flaps. As I've explained many times, there's one here and one there. These can seize open from oil getting into the intake where your CCV's ruptured, and they destroy the motor. The flap don't open and close properly. It ends up sticking on the flap, or the flap don't close at all, it becomes solid. These will cause rough running and to cause you to misfire, and also to lose low down power because the flap is not closing and opening properly to adjust the air mixture in the manifold. You gotta remember, it's a three stage running manifold, so therefore it regulates the air inside it to go into the combustion chamber to be burnt off to give more power. That's how BMW designed it. So be aware, they're not running at full efficiency. You will have your misfire and rough running codes. The next one on these, I get asked 24/7. So everyone will go and replace their manifold because they need to get to their CCV, which is behind. They will forget to disconnect this sensor right here, which is the map sensor on the back. You'll see the plug there. A lot of people don't even know that sensor's there, and they'll just rip out the manifold and then they'll rip the wires out of it. It's happened to many, many people, and trust me, it's happened to a lot of people. And then you come to me with this code for your map sensor, and that's because you guys didn't realize it was there, or you put your manifold back on and you haven't plugged that sensor back in, because a lot of you don't even look at it because you rush to remove your manifold without checking that one sensor. That sensor is the manifold absolute pressure sensor. If you ain't plugged in, you will have a heap of problems. Forget not just rough running, your car probably won't even start. So be sure to make sure you plug that back in and it's not broken because you haven't ripped it off in a rush. The next one that will cause rough running, leaks and vacuum systems is your MAF sensor. If that goes out, well, you guys know what's gonna happen there. You know you're gonna have rough running symptoms, you also know you're gonna have misfire. And a lot of you tell me you disconnect that and it makes your car run better. If you're disconnecting and your car's running better, that means you've got a problem somewhere else in the system. Unless you've got a scan tool, you're not gonna be able to tell. But if you're having a disconnector to make the car run better, that's because you've now pulled it into open loop. When it's in open loop, it's running off no sensors because you've disconnected one of the sensors that's meant to run in closed loop. Therefore, your car's gonna run the way it does on cold start and make it run just open on itself. Therefore, you've either got a problem with that sensor, which is on the closed loop, which is the Vanos solenoids. You've got a problem with the crank camshaft sensors. you could have a problem with your valvetronic motor, you could have a problem with your ignition coils. There's many, many things you could have a problem with. Do not disconnect this. I've not known these to go bad, but that being said, they could go bad on your side. So that's not to say they're not gonna go bad. The next one on these guys, which I get asked a lot, is when people change their valve cover. When people decide to change their valve cover, they remove the valvetronic motor. They don't have a tool to relearn the valvetronic position. Now, when I say relearn, I do not mean reprogram. A lot of people take this as me saying to reprogram. You do not have to reprogram anything. I get people asking me, do they have to reprogram a throttle body? Why is this myth that everyone seems to think that everything they touch on the engine needs reprogramming? Your car is not that special to need reprogramming. And no, BMW didn't make them that complicated. I know a lot of people want to seem like they're part of something or they're special, that their car needs reprogramming, to tell their friends that their car needs reprogramming like they're something special, but it's not a cool thing. As I've said to you many times, you don't want reprogramming. Nothing needs reprogramming. You can touch whatever you want on this car and it'll be fine. The only thing that needs to be relearned, and a scanner can do that for you, is your valvetronic motor. When you relearn it, it needs to relearn the steps, and that will cause your car not to start, and it will also cause really badly rough running, because as you see, it's on like a little wheel that goes on the eccentric shaft inside the valve cover itself, and it's on like a little turning wheel. Now that advances timing and de-advances the valves, opens and closes the valves, and it turns in and out constantly, and you'll see that when you remove the valvetronic motor. They have to be relearned. You cannot just do it with the ignition on and off cycle. It does not work. So do not believe anyone if they tell you that will work. I'm telling you right now, it doesn't. The next one on these is when people remove their valve cover and take out all their ignition coils, they forget one simple thing that will cause your car to crank but not start. And it's this ground wire right here. A lot of people forget to reattach that to the ignition coil bracket itself, where all the wiring sits, and back to the chassis. And as you see, it runs off the chassis and it's a ground wire. If you don't reconnect this, your car will crank but not start at all. You need to make sure this wire is connected at all times when you reconnect the ignition coils. If not, you will have issues and your car will not start. If you're getting rough running again, check your Vanos filters. Your Vanos filters are located down there. There's many, many videos online showing you how to clean them. I've not had to clean them because they very, very rarely fail and very rarely get dirty. If people are telling you they're dirty and you're getting rough running symptoms, the probable bet is your Vanos on is underwear or you've used cheap. I've told you many times, do not use cheap Chinese junk on these. Buy genuine BMW. You guys don't listen to me, and then you still come telling me that you've got the same issues. If you're not gonna listen to my advice and you're gonna use Chinese or you're gonna try and clean these, you do not clean these, you replace them. Therefore, don't ask me when you come back with your problems and your engine's destroyed because your timing chain has jumped where you're trying to advance the timing, where the solenoids cannot keep up with the demand of the DME. Your timing chain will end up jumping, causing you to have crankshaft codes that you didn't have before because you had your Chinese junk inside them. It's very simple. The way I see it, if you're having to buy Chinese parts for this car, you clearly can't afford it. Get rid of it now and give it to someone that can who ain't gonna neglect it, because these cars are not made to run on Chinese junk. The next one on these, which is gonna cause you rough running and vacuum leaks, is down here, all your CCV piping, which runs down here and runs back to the valve cover and back to the CCV itself, which is under located on the manifold here. On your black valve cover one, you're gonna have a wire pipe which comes off here and just goes to the valve cover itself over there. It's called the oil separator valve. When they crack from here or from oil, usually oil gets on the foam and then they end up, you know, just deteriorating over time from the heat of the engine. You end up with vacuum leaks, and then you end up with your idle all over the place when you first start on cold start. That's when you know it's CCV, PCV, whatever you guys want to call it, breather system, crankcase breather system, because what ends up happening is when it cracks, it ends up leaking out all the excess pressure. Now, that is used for cold start, especially to pull all the excess vacuum around the crank going back into the manifold. Once up to temperature, it doesn't do that. But it's used to help aid as well for cold starts. Now, when that is used so much to the point it ends up cracking and becoming brittle, and you guys need to replace the hose, and you know the hose ain't cheap, same as the valve cover. If you have got the plastic valve cover, and again, I'm gonna point you, you will have the CCV system built on the valve cover. You cannot replace them. I've seen people gluing them. I have seen people trying to replace them and being cheap. Go and buy a proper valve cover. If your valve cover is cracked, you will. And trust me when I'm telling you this, you will have rough running symptoms. Check your plastic valve cover. They do crack and will crack. Do not be cheap and try and glue it and seal it. Go and buy a new one. Your CCV sits on top of there. If it is cracked or whistling or anything, replace it immediately. Do not buy a Chinese part. Make sure you buy a proper, genuine BMW valve cover. It's a fact. On this engine, you don't even have to buy a new valve cover because it's the magnesium block. so the valve covers are perfect on these. But if it's plastic, you will need to buy a whole new valve cover. And the final one, if you're still getting rough symptoms after you've replaced everything I've told you to replace and it still ain't gone away, well then you need to go for the DME update, which many of you guys know I do it for many people. I update them all the time. The DME update is critical for your car. Without the latest firmware, your car will run like a bag of spanners. That is the fact. When you do the update, and I'm sure loads of you will agree with me who I've done it for, who watch these videos, will know that their cars run absolutely top notch after that update. And they cannot say it doesn't either. Their cars run at full power, more power than they ever thought necessary. You know, so if you haven't done the update, do the update on your M52 engine, and trust me, this car will completely transform. So there you have it guys, I've just gone over the M52 rough running, misfire and vacuum leaks. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video because it's something I get asked all the time, and I know you guys enjoy these M52 videos. I'm putting this out because I hope now it will help a lot of you who are sitting there questioning why M52 is not running right, why you've got a rough ride, or what you should be looking for, what you should be checking, what you should be cleaning. This should help you find all your misfires and common problems on this car. So thank you very much for watching guys, it's BMW Dr. Dean here, and goodbye.